It is September the 10th, 2021, and I'm here at Palo Verde High School. And I'm here every day for the ceremony to begin. It'll begin in just a few minutes. And we have the family here. Beautiful Gail Faye's approaching. She's the friend of Barbara, beloved Barbara Edwards, foreign language teacher also at Palo Verde High School. Right over here we have the family. We have a son, a nephew, son's family. These are all the family that's willing for this tribute. You can see this person, and of course the distinguished AFROTC cadets. Are lining the memorial. The ceremony is just moments away. To swing around right now and get our cadets because they do a spectacular job in rendering a great tribute to a great teacher, to America, to all of the people that we lost in 9/11. And at this memorial today, we do have the flag that flew over this monument in 2020. I'm just going to go ahead and get the flag. We did not have a ceremony in 2020 because of COVID. It's really important to go to the field office here. Students out here. All of them probably were not alive on 9/11. It makes remembering and having tributes.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Cadet Captain Larry Farouk, the Cadet Wing Commander for the Palo Verde Air Force Junior ROTC Unit. On behalf of our principal, Mrs. Amy Herring Smith, thank you for participating in our annual September 11th Barbara Edwards Memorial Rededication Ceremony. We're honored to have members from our police department, our fire department, and our military forces here today. Thank you for all that you do to protect us. Also here today is our school superintendent, Mr. Jesus Jara, our associate superintendent, Joe Petri, and our principal, Mrs. Smith. We're especially honored that members of Miss Barbara Edwards' family are here today to mark this solemn occasion. I'd like to recognize them at this time. Miss Edwards' son, Scott Edwards, is here with his wife, Christina, and two of Miss Edwards' grandchildren, Scott Jr. and Anna Barbara. And Miss Edwards' nephew, Brad Edwards, is here with his wife, Francine. Thank you all for traveling so far to be here with us. 20 years ago tomorrow, tragedy struck our school and our nation when terrorists attacked our country. Each year, we pay tribute to those who lost their lives that day, especially our own Miss Barbara Edwards, and to show our support for their families and friends. This rededication ceremony is proper and fitting to ever remind us of the sacrifices made every day by our armed forces and by all Americans who put themselves in harm's way to protect the freedoms we enjoy each day. As it states on the memorial, we will never forget. This year, for the first time in Nevada, we're flying the Freedom Flag during our ceremony. The Freedom Flag was created to honor the victims of the 9/11 attacks and to help us remember. We also have a relic from one of the Twin Towers in New York, and I invite you to examine it on the memorial after the ceremony. We will now bring the flag on the memorial to full staff so we may lower it for the final times. Teams!
On guard!
Attention!
Terry! Color!
Present!
Present!
Arms! At this time, Cadet Second Lieutenant Austin Anholt will play taps as we lower the flag that has flown over the memorial since July 19, 2021, for the last time. Present!
Present!
Arms! Members of the CCSD and Metropolitan Police Honor Guards have agreed to render honors to those who have made the ultimate sacrifice. I now invite them to render honors. I now invite Pipers Jason Bressler and Tucker Fleming of the Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department to play Amazing Grace.